There was an eerie stillness at the dead of the night. A young theology student walked past the dark and deserted Reichstag building when he saw a man with a burning object. On alerting the policemen nearby, they reached the scene of crime only to see the Reichstag building in flames. Marinus van der Labbe was the man identified and arrested. Naked from the waist upwards, smeared with dirt and sweating, he sat in front of them, breathing heavily. He had just, intentionally or unintentionally, paved the way for Hitler's ascent to a Fuhrer. The definitive stamp of 1941-1944, produced by Reichspost, features the head profile of Hitler. These magnificent-looking stamps come in multitude shades with varying denominations. In the later years, the stamp inscription Deutsches Reich, meaning German Empire, was changed to Gross Deutsches Reich, translating to Greater German Empire. Hitler's fierce oratory enabled him to seize control of the Nazi Party. In 1924, Hitler and his henchmen attempted an armed coup against the Vienna government. It failed, and he was sentenced to 9 months. In jail, he wrote a book, Mein Kampf, in which he blamed Germany's defeat on the Jews and his plans for seeking new territories in the East. An opportunity arose for Hitler when in the 1932 elections he became the Chancellor. He blamed the Reichstag fire on the communists and demanded emergency powers, which he used to ban other political parties. On President Hindenburg's death, Hitler declared himself the President. And on 2nd August 1934, he became the absolute Führer of Germany. This totalitarian empire came to be known as Third Reich or the Nazi Germany. The symbol of swastika became its infamous logo. During this period, coins of 1, 2, 5, 10 and 50 Reichspfennig were struck at 7 mint facilities. The reverse illustrates the denomination, while the obverse depicts an image of the Nazi eagle clutching the swastika along with the date and legend, Deutsches Reich. The foreign powers failed to stop the rise of Nazi Germany. Hitler now implemented his plans for world domination with the annexation of Austria, Czechoslovakia and Poland, which led to a war with France. These countries felt compelled to issue postage stamps of Hitler, which depicted the dominance of the Nazi power over the conquered territories. Italy produced Mussolini-Hitler stamps celebrating the Rome-Berlin Axis. Hold zinc coins in 5 and 10 Reichspfennig denominations and banknotes of 1, 2, 5, 20, 50 Reichsmark and 50 Reichspfennig served as legal tender alongside the currency of the occupied countries during the time of the war. In the opening years of Second World War, Hitler's war machine won a series of stunning victories, conquering the great part of continental Europe. The foreign powers, in a desperate attempt to suppress Germany, launched a series of secret missions. One of them was Operation Cornflakes. On 5th January 1945, a mail train made its way to Linz, Austria. Suddenly, a US plane swooped, dropping a bomb on the train. The explosion left the train derailed and its mail cargo scattered all over the area. Then came a second plane, dropping a bag of fresh mail around the train containing enormous amount of propaganda letters. While clearing up the mess, the German postal workers recovered the bags and delivered their contents, unaware of the seditious material hidden within. Operation Cornflakes had begun. It was thought that the distribution of propaganda letter through the German postal system would undermine the support of Adolf Hitler. Hence, every aspect of the German postal system was replicated, down to the smallest detail. The forgers manipulated the stamps on some letters bearing Adolf Hitler's face to show the German Führer's exposed skull. Beneath, the country tag, which read Deutsches Reich, was changed to Fuchsches Reich, meaning ruined empire. This mission was not so successful due to certain oversights, but the stamps are highly valued. In the coming years, Hitler turned to be a megalomaniac and a fanatical leader. He felt adamant to get rid of the Jews from the world and ordered all manpower to fulfill this horrendous task in the so-called concentration camps. An estimated 6 million Jews died. In the May of 1945, Hitler committed suicide. Out of all tyrants in history, Adolf Hitler certainly topped the list, leading his country and many others into abyss.